he sat down and said, I am Oliver.
Wow, bold.
And I was like, we'll see. But he was right.
Thank you. I'm sorry I don't know your name. I'm Felix.
Oliver.
Oliver. Oliver, I love you. I love you. All right, cheers, Ollie.
Congratulations on Saltburn. This is my film of the year.
Yay! Thank you very much.
And Promising Young Woman was also my film of the year.
Thank you.
It's just amazing. Call me crazy, but I kind of want Rosamund Pike and Richard E. Grant as my parents in this.
Oh, totally. I mean, they'd ruin your life. But would you care?
No.
No, me neither.
Oh, how wonderful.
Yeah, I told you it wasn't a minger.
Oh, but darling, you're kind about everyone.
They are the best.
The chemistry between Jacob and Barry is just ridiculous. When did you realise it had to be those two?
I mean, it's so, honestly, casting is just like the most important thing when it comes to any film, but certainly when you're talking about kind of desire and all of the sort of sticky things that this film is about. So I knew that Barry would make the most amazing Oliver quite early on. I'd seen his work before and just thought he was the most compelling, fascinating, like unique performer. And so I met him and I just knew he would be incredible. I think he sat down and said, I am Oliver.
Wow, bold.
And I was like, we'll see. But he was right. And then with Jacob, it was just, I'd met him. I hadn't seen any of his work at that point, and I'd met him and just thought he was so interesting, exactly the sort of person that I'm kind of always, like, thrilled to meet. He was really honest and direct and funny. And then he just came in and auditioned for Felix, and he just did the most. I mean, he did what he did on screen, which is, like, this unbelievably deft bit of observational comedy, this, like, brilliantly funny, charming, impossible to get right. And him and Barry just, they got on like a house on fire right from the beginning. And they're still incredibly close. And I think it just, yeah, it's so much about these two and that kind of tension and that friendship and that bond and that kind of power dynamic between them that it was so important that they kind of were close and trusted each other. Yeah.
They were just perfect together.
They were perfect,
We've got to talk about that final sequence because I haven't stopped playing Murder on the Dance Floor since I saw the film.
Yes.
Did you always know you wanted to use that song? And also, how game was Barry?
So I think, I always wanted to use Murder on the Dance Floor because it's the perfect amount of kind of jubilant, joyful, wry and camp, which I think this film absolutely required. And the thing is, you know, Barry is, he's like me, he just wants to go for the most complicated, he wants to kind of go for the highest level of difficulty, I guess. And we're both determined to sort of make something that feels challenging and complicated and sexy, but funny. And, you know, all of the stuff that I guess this film is, which is, you know, it's a certainly kind of an erotic thriller, I suppose, but it's mostly a comedy, a dark comedy. And yeah, it was a joy to work with him because he's always as ready as I am to do the thing that other people will be disapproving of.
When this film comes out, that scene is going to break the internet.
Oh, God.
It really is.
Oh, Lord.
And I can't wait for it. I feel like there's so many Easter eggs in this as well.
Yeah.
Are there any that you think that people won't pick up on?
I mean, I think that the problem with Easter eggs is, I mean, absolutely, you know, so much of the way that I love to work is to kind of acknowledge the world that this world kind of comes from, I guess. You know, there are the kind of books and films and, you know, the work that has inspired this film, that this film is sort of in direct conversation with. Absolutely, there are like tons of Easter eggs because isn't that the fun of filmmaking, that every single detail is something that's, you know, that will tell you, that will give you information. But at the same time, I definitely wouldn't talk about them because so much of the pleasure is noticing them yourself. There are a few things that people have like come to me at the end of screenings, maybe like the third time they've seen it and they're like, oh my God, I noticed this thing. And it's always so fun, but yeah. I won't give any of them away now.
I can't wait to see it for a second time just to try, because I feel like I'll find them for the second watch. My favourite kind of films are ones like this with just incredible twists. What movies were you watching, writing and making this?
I mean, I think it's definitely part of this kind of Gothic country house tradition. So I was looking, we were looking a lot at, you know, Rebecca by Alfred Hitchcock and The Go-Between and The Servant by Joseph Losey. And we were looking at Merchant Ivory. We were looking at Peter Greenaway, who did like unbelievably brilliant, horrifying horror romance thrillers. It's just a lifetime of being obsessed with this genre, I think, and of kind of, you know, loving it to death, squeezing it until it passes out, I guess, is sort of what Saltburn is.
Oh, that's just giving me goosebumps. Look, Pamela.
Oh, no.
The script is absolutely hilarious. Rosamund particularly really got me. What are your favourite lines from this?
Oh, God.
There are so many.
I mean, I really love Rosamund's delivery of, I was a lesbian once, you know, but it was all too wet for me in the end. Men are so lovely and dry.
That was my favourite. That broke me. I was howling.
She's just a master. She's a master.
She really is.
Yeah.
I had the best time watching this. Thank you so much for making it. Hearing everyone gasping and laughing in the cinema, it was amazing.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.